the fact that he even felt he needed to be tested to prove. There's been a lot of ruckus lately about whether Kinabody uses steroids or not. There's this video of him waving around test results like it's a flag to prove he's natty. Let me start off by saying that failing a steroid drug test only means you're stupid or careless. Passing a steroid drug test means absolutely nothing. There is no test in the world that can prove that you are and always have been natty, period. Every drug test out there, competitors can easily get around. So the fact that Kinabody has a piece of paper that shows he passed a test means absolutely nothing. Now let's talk about steroid drug testing as it relates to the very popular men's physique contest. Some of the biggest supplement endorsement contracts go to the winners of these men's physique contests. Because these contestants are paraded around as being naturally achievable, they're perfect vehicles to be salesmen for the billion-dollar supplement industry. So when six-figure supplement endorsements are at stake, the incentives to cheat are huge. Many of the natural bodybuilding federations have made gallant efforts to keep their contest steroid free. But it's still the honor system. These tests, as I mentioned before, are very easy to get around. And the competitors in these natural competitions know who's clean and who's not. So it's really only peer pressure that keeps people honest in these. Still, the incentives to cheat are huge, even in these natural events, because for someone trying to start up a fitness business, it's a huge feather in their cap to say that they won a natural bodybuilding competition. So you got to be careful with these too. Now let's talk about steroid testing in YouTube fitness personalities. There are a number of people on YouTube making six-figure salaries selling nutritional programs and workout programs that will get you big gains fast. The incentives to cheat here are huge. If you rack up 30 pounds muscle gain a year for a couple years in a row while using steroids but pretending to be natty, you can pretend you have the secret and you can show others how to do it. But don't believe it. Now let's talk about why passing a drug test means nothing. Let me sum it up for you. Money. Lots of money. Pro sports are huge business. There are a number, hundreds of players earning over $10 million a year. They have a huge incentive to pass drug tests. Compare that to the pittance that the organizations, the anti-doping organizations have to do the testing. They are outspent $10,000 to one. There's only about 300 substances on the banned substances list. Every year, they come up with another dozen more steroid or steroid type products that will not be discovered by the current round of drug tests. The drug testers simply cannot keep up. There's too much money involved in cheating. The other problem is these sports really don't want to catch the cheaters. It's good business. It's money. People who like watching baseball like home run records. If someone is going to set a home run record, it fills stadiums the whole season. They want people to cheat. When they get caught, they only make token efforts to pretend they're cleaning up. Take football. How many people do you think would watch NFL football if linemen were 180-pound natty vegans? It would be like ping pong balls bouncing off each other down on the field. Nobody wants to watch that. People, the sports want cheaters. How do you know if the fitness trainer you're following is natural or not and has got their gains without cheating? Great question, but let me ask you a question first. How would it affect your training if you knew the answer with certainty? How would it affect your training if you knew whether Jeff Side, Matt Ogus, Elon Gabay, Scooby 1961, whether they had used steroids or not? How would it affect your training? The answer is it wouldn't. Comparing yourself to others leads you down a path of self-destruction. Everyone is different. Everyone has different genetics. Everyone has different obstacles. All you can do is work out as hard as you can, work out as smart as you can, eat as clean as you can, live as clean as you can, and get lots of sleep. You can't do anything else. If you're doing those things, you're going to gain muscle and strength at the maximum possible rate. It doesn't matter what anyone else does. The biggest question for last. So, how do you know what's possible to gain naturally and how fast? Great question. I know I'm going to sound like a broken record here, but please use my muscle gain calculator. Look at my expectations page. They will tell you what is a reasonable amount of muscle to gain in a year based on your age, your lifting experience, your genetics, and so forth. You can't gain more than that. So I don't care what anyone promises you. In fact, if their workout program promises you more than my expectation page or my muscle gain calculator say, then I would be very, 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 very suspicious about them and their workout program. They're just telling you what you want to hear to get your money. So you need to have good expectations. That is it for today. Sorry for the long video, but an important subject. And one final point. I wanted to point out that this cap was handmade by Helen, age 99, one of our good friends. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Bis nächstem Mal. Auf Wiedersehen.